Sugar Hill, baby.
Oh, Sugar Hill, dude, you're taking me back.
Sugar Hill, baby.
Taking me back. How about that movie? Wesley. Michael Wright.
Man.
You know who played Kami in that is the little kid who gets shot?
Who?
Donald Faison. How about that, man?
That is a young Donald Faison.
How good is that?
See?
Well, I made another movie with later, who's one of the great, I don't know if you must have interviewed. You ever interviewed Donald?
No.
One of the great guys of all time.
Man.
Ever. Just hilarious, too.
We can talk all day about Sugar Hill.
I love that you're pulling out Sugar Hill on me. That movie's intense.
Yes, sir. It is.
I know.
I remember being a kid watching it. It was like, man, that's what I want to act.
Yeah.
I want to act. You've had the opportunity to produce many films from Dawn of the Dead to Sugar Hill.
Yeah, Sugar Hill.
And you chose Flash of Genius for your directorial debut.
Yeah.
Why?
Well, you know, you were saying Sugar Hill is a movie that you love and it had a resonance with you.
Yeah.
You know, I could name 20 movies and say to you, well, what about this one, this one, this one? Some of you might more or less, but there was something about that that just got you. You went, yeah, I dig the whole thing, the way it looked. And when I read the script, it was just the same way. I just read the script and I loved the story about this guy who comes up with this crazy invention that, you know, you don't ever even think about and then decides to go out and produce it, and then they get screwed, and he decides, you know what, man? Not going to take it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just, by the way, not yours, mine.
Yeah.
And when everybody's trying to say, hey, just back off, take some money, leave, and he's going, no, you don't understand.
Mm-hmm.
This is my invention.
Yeah,
you want me to leave? That's fine. Just say I invented it, and nobody will do it. So he just gets deeper and deeper, and I don't know, I guess I just love that kind of a attitude.
Yes, sir.
You know?
Yes, sir. You know, one thing that I really liked about the story, it was a true story. It was based on a true story. And I think, you know, with Hollywood today, it's a lot of remakes. Could you share a little bit of your thoughts about true story versus Hollywood? You know, with true story, you get substance. Sometimes with Hollywood.
Well, I think that it to be honest, Kelly, I don't think you necessarily... one is better than the other. I think you can do a remake of something and I think it can be fine.
Okay.
I think it's all about how you approach it and how much respect you have for what you're going to do.
Okay.
And you could take a true story of your favorite true story in the world and in the wrong hands, you'd go, oh my God, I'm going to shoot myself.
Mm-hmm.
They took that story. I love that story.
Yeah.
And that guy they cast doesn't look at all like that guy. And they gave the wrong, you know what I mean? And just, you could be really, you know, steamed about it.
Yes, sir.
So I think that it's really just about how responsible and how committed and passionate somebody is about the material.
Mm-hmm.
I don't have an interest. Look, there's so certain films you can remake, and I've done that.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm guilty.
Mm-hmm.
Dawn of the Dead, we did a version of it, but we did it really respectfully.
Yeah,
and we cast it up, and we didn't just try to make a cheesy movie.
Yeah.
And Zack Snyder was a talented director, and
he
went on to direct 300 and now Watchmen, so obviously he had some chops.
Mm-hmm.
I love true stories, and historically Hollywood has loved true stories, whether they were making a story about Van Gogh, or they're making The Insider, or they're making Aaron Brockovich, or they're making a movie like, you know, we made Flash of Genius.
Mm-hmm.
It's all about commitment and how, and you know, if you get lucky too, you got to have guys to, you know, you can get Greg Kinnear, and he got this guy. He got him.
Yeah.
Now, as a director versus a producer,
yeah.
Why don't you talk a little bit about that real quick for me?
Well, they're both in the movie making business, but they're much different. You know, one of them is you're basically trying to get as a producer, you're sort of trying to get everything together so that you can go make the movie.
Yeah.
Once you're making the movie, it's pretty much in the director's hands.
Yeah. Did you have somebody on your back? Come on.
No, you know what? To my great, you know, gratitude and respect, my producers were fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
And I think they trusted I knew how to produce a movie after producing 30 of them. And if they had seen something they didn't like, they would have stepped in. Because these guys, you know, Gary Barber and Roger Birnbaum, the guys have produced many, many movies.
Mm-hmm.
But they didn't. They said to me, we're going to give you not a lot of dough, but here's some dough. We love this story, and as long as you stick to what you said you're going to do, and they felt that I was delivering that, they just said, good on you. Keep on doing it, man. They did not, you know, and sometimes I would ask their opinions because they're smart guys, do you think we got this? And sometimes they say, well, maybe you need a little more of this, or let's shoot that. But most of the time, I had a very supportive team. I mean, you know, knock on wood, I got lucky that way.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. Sugar Hill.
Yeah, Mr. Sugar Hill.
I appreciate it.